Thank you for listening to the show on Really Big Something Channel. September 11th, 2017.
The Cooner Report, presented by Kelly Financial Services.
This is the Cooner Report.
Florida underwater. Okay, my friends, jam-packed show for you today. It is obviously the 16th anniversary of the 9/11 terrorist attacks. We will discuss that legacy as well at 2:05. Bannon Unleashed, an incredible interview with 60 Minutes. One of the most fascinating interviews I've ever heard. We're going to discuss that as well. But first, my friends, Hurricane Irma ravages South Florida. Here is now the absolute latest. So, Irma is now hammering Florida with massive heavy winds, raging floodwaters. Some of the pictures are just, I mean, literally stunning. Downtown Miami, you see streets where it's almost like rivers going through these streets. There is so much surge floodwaters, flooding taking place. Apparently now 3 million people in Florida at a minimum have lost power. There are now entire cities flooded. That is now ranked as the 7th worst storm in U.S. history. And as all of this is taking place, curfews are still being enacted. Residents want to return home, but they can't, at least for another 24 hours. And in this vacuum of chaos and lawlessness, the looters are now pouring in and starting to take over the flooded streets of parts of Florida. And in particular, so far, at least 32 looters have been arrested across Florida during an Irma crime spree. And so they're looting everything. They're looting electronic stores. They're looting gun stores. The big one, though, it seems to be footwear. In Florida, in Fort Lauderdale, Florida, ABC News crew actually filmed 8 people breaking into Simon Sportswear in Fort Lauderdale. They smashed the windows, they went in, and they were hauling out boxes. Air Jordans, sneakers, high tops, you name it, they were hauling it out. Apparently, just down the road, a Foot Locker was also looted and pillaged. They don't know if it's the same group of people or if it's a different group of people, but notice they're not looting grocery stores. Have you noticed they're not stealing food? Now, don't get me wrong. You shouldn't loot, period. But, you know, I don't know. Okay, Jeff, there's no power. City's underwater. There's 3, 4, 5 feet of water in certain parts of Florida. People are desperate. People are hungry. They want to go and get food. I'm not saying you should do it, but I could wrap my mind around it. Well, okay, they're hungry. They're thirsty. Okay, they're hitting the local Stop and Shops. But they're not looting food or water. No. They're looting the good stuff. They're looting the merchandise. And as I mentioned this to Brittany when we were discussing the show before we, in our pre-show meeting, who the hell is hauling out flat screen TVs and computers and laptops when you've got 50, 60 mile an hour winds and you've got rain barreling down on you? Like who does that? Who's hauling out $200 pairs of sneakers when you've got, I mean, your city is underwater, your state is underwater, your fellow citizens are hurting, and your first instinct is to take advantage that the police aren't on the scene, and so to take advantage of this lawlessness, and so it's to pillage, plunder, loot, steal? It's disgusting. It's disgusting. And it shows you again what I have been saying for I don't know how many years, why we need law enforcement and why we need the police. Because it is a thin blue line between civilization and barbarism. It's a thin blue line. And I guess the police are preoccupied doing other things. And so when they're not out on the streets in Florida, sorry, in Fort Lauderdale in particular, if they're not out on the streets in Fort Lauderdale, it's the gangbangers and the thieves and the hoodlums. They're the ones that take over. Now, furthermore, I want to throw something else on the table, and then I want to get your reaction. 617-266-6868 is the number if you want to be part of the show. It's still early. We're still assessing the damage of Hurricane Irma, and in fact, it's still hitting some parts of Florida, although, thank God, it's been downgraded now from a hurricane to a tropical storm. So thank the Lord. So hopefully the worst is now over. But compare Hurricane Harvey to Hurricane Irma. And I don't mean just in terms of the damage, because we don't know that yet. We're going to find out soon. The response of the community, and in particular, you didn't see nowhere near the same kind of thievery, the same kind of violence. I mean, there's shootings. Literally, there's shootings in places like in Tampa Bay. And in other parts of Florida, there's a standoff between SWAT teams and people with guns, and they're shooting one another. Because these thugs are breaking in and looting stores and businesses. You did not see that. I'm not saying it didn't happen in isolated incidents, but you did not see anything on this scale in Houston or on the coast in Texas, in Galveston, as you're seeing in Florida. And so the question is this: why was there so much less crime, so much less looting, so much less thievery, so much less mass violence and criminality in Texas than there is right now taking place in Florida? What's the difference? And my honest opinion, okay, like I'm in the confessional, I think it's Texas's gun culture. I know people in Florida have the right to carry. I understand that. I understand they have good, strong, solid gun rights in Florida. I understand that. But Texas has not just they're very proud of the Second Amendment. But Texas has a gun culture whereby you know that if you break into somebody's house or you break into somebody's business or you want to break into a Foot Locker or a sportswear store, chances are somebody's got a shotgun. And they're going to give you 5 seconds. Son, what do you lack more? The sneakers or your laugh? Take your pick. And usually you're going to say, yeah, you know what? You know what? My life. Thank you. Thank you. Adios. In other words, because of the right to bear arms, because people are carrying in Houston or in Texas, because people there cherish the Second Amendment, and because everybody in Texas knows my neighbor most likely is carrying a gun, they are able to protect themselves. You know what? I better be very careful. Because if I start looting, and if I start stealing, and if I start burglarizing, you know what? I may get it right between the eyes. And the liberal media doesn't want to tell you this, but that is an incredible disincentive to looting, to pillaging, to criminal behavior, or to violence. I think, to me, there's just no question about that. And so my question to you is this: what is your reaction now to the looting that is taking place in Florida? And why do you think there was so much less criminality and violence in Texas with Hurricane Harvey than there is right now in Florida being hammered by Hurricane Irma? Is it Texas's gun culture? Is this what really makes the difference between civilization and barbarism, knowing that your neighbor may be packing? 617-266-6868. Okay, lines are blazing. Nathan in Tampa, you're up first. Nathan, please tell me, how are you doing and how's Tampa holding up?
What's up, Jeff? Tampa's doing good. We're doing good. Some minor damage. We almost lost the house, but thank God we had a big oak tree fall and missed all the cars and missed our house. So, yeah, God watching over us last night.
Nathan, do you have power?
That we do not have power.
Do you have any idea when you're going to get power restored?
No, that I don't know, but what I do know is that there's people in Tampa posing as electrical workers for Tampa Electric, and they're going around houses robbing people at gunpoint.
Oh, my God.
Yep.
Oh, my God. Nathan, how is the situation in Tampa, and what are you hearing in terms of violence? Are there any shootings? Are you hearing of looting, crime?
I'm hearing of those robberies, the gunpoint robberies. I'm hearing, I heard one, there was 12 looters got busted, and I know one was held up in a gun store, and they had to send a SWAT after him. So it's a, I don't know why people decide that this is a perfect time to go out and do that kind of stuff, but you got crazy moon bats everywhere, Jeff, including Tampa.
Nathan, I mean, obviously it's a bit of an academic question for you because you're still trying to take care of yourself and your family, but why do you think, as you're listening to me now, obviously you have no power, you're there in Tampa Bay, why do you think in Texas you just didn't see this? Is it because everybody knows in Texas people are carrying?
It's guns, Jeff. The places, the rural, more rural areas here in Florida and Tampa, I'm hearing nothing of the looting happening. It's all in the cities, the rural areas where all the guns are. I got some friends that live in some rural areas here in Florida, and they're packed to the teeth, 20-something guns apiece, so, and they've had nothing happen to them. So it's mainly in the cities right now.
Nathan, if you don't mind me asking, and if it's a personal question, if it's too personal, please let me know. Do you have a gun? Are you able to protect yourself and your family?
Yes, sir. We like the Second Amendment in my house.
Good. Good. Nathan, please stay safe. You're in our thoughts and prayers. If there's anything we can do for you, you let us know, okay?
Yes, sir.
Nathan, God bless you.
God bless you, too.
Take care, my friend. Stay safe. 617-266-6868. Okay. From what I've been reading in news reports, Tampa, they thought they were going to get, quote-unquote, punched in the face. That's what the mayor said in terms of Hurricane Irma. It appears it's not as bad as it could have been. So parts of Florida, people were expecting it even worse than it is now. But thankfully, the damage could have been even worse. I just hope this thing goes away and we can restore law and order as quickly as possible. Mike in Cape Cod. Go ahead, Mike.
Hey, Jeff. Good show as usual.
Thank you, Mike.
You know, I got deployed to Hurricane Andrew. I had talked about this on the show this morning on the Cape. And I got deployed as a contractor attached to the National Guard units. And as we were coming out of Miami through Coral Gables, and it was from there down to Homestead was absolutely annihilated. But as we got into the Homestead area to work, the looting and the armed robberies, I mean, we were even given sidearms because at night when we would have to go into different developments to clear the roads out, there was, scurrying around like rats stealing everything. It was horrendous what people will really do. I mean, yes, I can understand if it was, stores or something for food or Pampers or something for a child or whatever, just survival. I understand that. And it was that bad, but people have no conscience. And when they were down there, I mean, the bottom line is, as I was telling your producer, if we had chief of polices or mayors or even governors that would do their job. I hate to say it, but sometimes you got to kill a couple hostages in order to get their attention. And you wouldn't be having this if you just went by the law of what is it there? Martial justice or whatever it is when it comes
frontier
to
justice. Yeah, frontier justice.
All right. Martial law. That's what I'm saying. And it's not, and that's why this gets, the people of this country know they're going to get away with it. And if we don't get back to basics on running this country the way it used to be, it's lost because, you know, something like this or something even like in New York, when I went down there for that in Ground Zero, there was none of that. Oh, God, that's one thing about New York is they would have none of it. You know, Mike, if something was, if there was a gold watch on the side of the road, nobody was picking it up.
Mike, I'm up against it, but I want to ask you something, and I want to ask the audience this as well, both you and the audience. When we looked at Hurricane Harvey, we saw those pictures, literally, of neighbor helping neighbor. You know, the it's almost an iconic picture now. There was a guy with a cap carrying, I think she's an Asian woman or an Hispanic woman with her clutching her baby. And everybody marveled at that. How come we're not seeing that in Florida? What's, I understand, okay, the gun culture, okay, that's part of it. But what's happening, why was Texas, the solidarity was there, and in Florida, it's every thief and gangbanger for himself?
Well, we still had problems from what I understand through a few people I talked to. At the Cajun Navy down there was trying to help people, and there were still people on other boats trying to rob people. There were some problems down there. I mean, the Texas, that area was a lot better, was because I think the people down there are more conservative and they have more heart. You know, when you get into Miami, Miami takes care of itself. It really does. Miami's a good community. A lot of the Cuban people that came from Cuba, they really made a life there, and they're very proud of their city. And I've seen that over the years. But once you start getting past Coral Gables and the Cutler Ridge, and Cutler Ridge is very wealthy. I mean, very wealthy area. And then as it goes down, it just becomes, it's mayhem. It's just the slums. And that's what happens. And I say it how I see it. And a lot of people don't like it when I do things like that. Or I say,
oh, good for you, Mike. Good for you.
It was catastrophic down there. And I wouldn't have thought one second if I was being robbed, I would have blown somebody away or to protect property.
God bless you.
That's just the way it is.
Mike, God bless you. Thank you for that call. 617-266-6868. Let me tell you the difference. Nobody has the guts to say it. I'm going to say it. When the moon bats take over an area, look how they behave. Texas is conservative. Those parts of Florida, most of it, liberal. Liberalism versus conservatism. There you have it. One loots, the other one helps. 1226 here on the great WRKO. Okay, Hurricane Irma hammers Florida. There are now reports of mass looting taking place. They're taking everything. They're looting electronic stores, a Foot Locker, sportswear stores, gun racks, you name it, they're stealing it. 617-266-6868. John in Michigan. Go ahead, John.
Greetings, Mr. Cooner.
Hi.
It's nice to talk to you again.
John, please call me Jeff. I'm not that important, John.
I apologize. It's just I got so excited the last time I had called in here. I was the one who had called you after.
No, that's okay. No, you get me nervous when you say Mr. Cooner. I'm thinking, are you from the IRS? Are you from IRS or something?
Anybody could use some money, but I don't want your money, Jeff. But anyway, I wanted to call in and talk to you about, you know, why there was less looting in Texas versus in Florida.
Yes.
When I first came back from my deployment to Afghanistan back in 2014, my ex-girlfriend and I went to visit family. And I will say this, if you've never gone to Houston, Texas, Jeff, do yourself a favor and take a family trip or even a work trip if you can, and go down there during the 3-week Houston rodeo. What I witnessed down there was not only a bunch of proud people, but a bunch of family-oriented people. And I will say this, Jeff, if you've never gone to Texas, it feels like you've come home to a place that you've never been, that feels like home. And I say that because when I walked into the gate, they had a fair going on, and it was at the stadium where the Houston Texans, the NFL, play. And you just looked around, and you saw families of every color getting along. There was no fights. There was no, you know, big outbursts of violence or anything. It's people eating deep-fried cupcakes and smoked turkey legs, enjoying it. And then you get to go inside, and you watch the rodeo and whatnot. And then after that, there would be a concert that would play that night. And at that night time, it was Alan Jackson, if I remember correctly.
So, John, what you're saying is it's not just that Texas is a gun culture. It's more than that. It's a conservative culture.
Absolutely, Jeff. And that's why I said it feels like you've come home if you've never been there. And I had to go to El Paso for pre-mobilization training, so I was on the other side of the state. But we went to visit family of my girlfriend at the time, and I will tell you, If WRKO will send you there for something, or if you
I'd love to go.
And the kids, I'm telling you, go down there for a family function of some sort like that. And I would recommend the 3-week Houston rodeo. You go down there and check it out, because you'll say, wow, I feel like I'm home, but I've never been here, and I would definitely check it out, Jeff.
John, phenomenal call. You know what? I think you hit the nail right on the head. The difference between the reaction to Hurricane Harvey and what we're now seeing in parts of Florida to Hurricane Irma. Jeff in Chelsea. Go ahead, Jeff.
Yes. All your callers took the wind out of my sails, but here's my contribution to the program. If you look at the video of the people looting, they're blacks. A lot of those people are blacks, and Florida has a very high Haitian population. And when you get into the minds of these gangbangers, all that's on their minds is screw Whitey. It's just as simple as that. Whitey screwed us, so we're going to return the favor. It's communist class warfare. It's just-
Jeff, but hold on. Let me ask you this, though. Yeah. I mean, Hurricane Harvey, you saw many African Americans rescuing white women, white children. To me, the difference is not black-white. I think it's what we're talking about. It's Christian, non-Christian.
Yes.
Exactly. It's pride and not having pride in your community.
That's why I say your callers took the wind out of my sails, because I feel the same way as your callers. It's the difference between Christian and non-Christian, because if you study Haiti, the way that is, Haiti is completely communist. And you see, when you have people with a communist Democrat mindset, they're looking at me, even if it's a black owner of that store, he's a sellout. I want to get everything from him. It's communism. Communism is envious of people that have more wealth.
Thank you for that call, Jeff. Okay, 617-266-6868. My friends, even Miss America has now become politicized. You're not going to believe this one. Don't touch that dial.
WRKO, the voice of Boston.
My friends, is it time to finally get rid of the Miss America beauty pageant? I'm telling you, after yesterday, I'm starting to think maybe the answer is yes. So now they've even politicized Miss America. Even now, Miss America gets political. So, as you know, over 50 contestants vie for the crown to be Miss America and then eventually compete for Miss Universe. Well, when they went to the final five, they changed the format a little bit this year from just asking them one question to asking them two questions. One was a playful question. The other one was a more serious question. And take a guess. When all of the five, I guess, what do you want to call them? Five finalists. When the five finalists were asked the so-called serious question, take a guess what kind of questions they were asked. Anti-Trump questions. Every question was designed, a setup, for them to go ahead and bash the president. So, for example, Miss Missouri was asked about whether Trump colluded with Russia. Now, her answer was, there's no evidence so far that he did collude with Russia, but of course the investigation should continue, and, you know, the DOJ should start prosecuting if they can find evidence, but so far there's no evidence. Well, that pretty much, okay, kiss away, blank you, Miss Missouri, that's not the right answer. Then they asked another one about whether Confederate statues should be taken down in the wake of Charlottesville. And of course, that answer was yes, but they should be put into museums. You know, in other words, you got to grease everybody a little bit. Well, you know, history's important, the statues are important, but let's stick them into a museum, basically where nobody can see them, for the most part. It's pretty much most of the public will never see them. But the winner was Miss North Dakota, Kara Mund, who was asked, do we have the actual question, Brittany? Okay. Who was asked this question and then gave this very politically correct anti-Trump answer. Roll it, Brittany.
195 countries signed the Paris Agreement, in which each country sets non-binding goals to reduce man-made climate change. The U.S. is withdrawing from the agreement, citing negligible environmental effects and negative economic impact. Good decision? Bad decision? Which is it and why?
I do believe it's a bad decision. Once we reject that, thank you. Once we reject that, we take ourselves out of the negotiation table, and that's something that we really need to keep in mind. There is evidence that climate change is existing, so whether you believe it or not, we need to be at that table, and I think it's just a bad decision on behalf of the United States.
You know, I'm listening to this, and I'm asking myself, like, okay, look, first of all, let's be honest, okay? In a contest where the women are told to walk around in bikinis, you know, forgive me, but that's what it is. They're told around to walk around in bikinis and high heels. You know, this emphasis on the question and how they answered the question and how much knowledge they have of current affairs. That's not really why you win, Miss America. So, number one, all of these moonbats, these liberals, keep trying to politicize Miss America. And I'm asking myself, you know, you're the one that keeps going on about sexism, misogyny, mistreatment of women, objectification of women. There's nothing more quote-unquote sexist, quote-unquote misogynistic, quote-unquote the objectification of women than, frankly, Miss America. Okay, that's the obvious point. Point numero uno. Point number two. Ay, 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 does this woman not know what she's talking about? Ay, ay, ay. So, yes, it's bash Trump for pulling out of the climate change accords. The question itself answers itself. It's non-binding, in theory. Well, if it's non-binding, and if climate change is, as you say, so real, so why are we signing a non-binding agreement? I mean, if we're all going to die, because we're all burning up on the planet. The planet's got a fever, as Al Gore would put it. Well, if it's a non-binding agreement, it's non-binding. So how much good is it going to do if it's non-binding? That's point number one. It's an obvious point. The deeper point is this. It's a jobs killer. It's a jobs killer. Now, the politically incorrect answer would have been President Trump did the exact right thing. It's what he campaigned on. It's what he told the American people to do. And frankly, I'm happy I have a president who puts the interests of Pittsburgh over Paris, who puts the interests of his own citizens and workers over those of the globalist elites. If she had said anything like that, she never would have gotten that crown. I don't care how good she looks in a bikini. Okay? I don't care how good she looks in high heels. I don't care how good her hairstyle is. Out. She never would have won. So, if you peddle the line, if you toe the line on climate change and you stick it to the president, you bash Trump, you now become Miss America. To me, it has now descended into a circus and a farce. Miss America now to me is really, it's a circus and a farce. It's a joke. It really is. And you know, Jared made a very good point to me before we did the show today. He said, you know, Jeff, it's the same left-wingers who keep going on about fascism, 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 fascism. But notice, you always have to give the state-approved answer. Just like under the old fascist regime, you always have to give the political orthodoxy, the politically correct answer that the regime, the left-wing, politically correct regime demands. Because if you don't toe their line, you're just not going to win. I think Miss America is frankly outdated. I think the pageant now has really become a joke. It's now becoming a sounding board where they just go for one left-wing political shill after another, for one trendy, fashionable left-wing cause after another. And I think it's time we got rid of it. That's just my honest opinion. Who needs it? 617-266-6868. It is the Cooner Country poll question of the day. Sponsored by Bill Kelly Financial Services. Should we get rid of the Miss America beauty pageant? Has it now just become too politicized? If you believe the answer is yes, and frankly on this one I'm a big yes, text the letter A to 680-680. If you believe the answer is no, Jeff, it's been there for how many decades? It's part of American culture. Yes, it's a bit stupid now with the liberal politically correct questions, but that may correct itself. In other words, keep it. text the letter B to 680-680. As always, you can vote online at WRKO.com. Skippy in Southie, you're up first. Go ahead, Skippy.
Jeff, this year, though, there is normally 50 contestants. This year, there was only 49. And I was trying to figure out why it wasn't, and found out that none of the girls wanted to wear the sash that says Idaho.
Oh, Russ, you're up next. Go ahead, Russ.
First of all, Jeff, I could give a good bleep less. At the age of 70, sex doesn't sell anymore. You know what I mean? Oh, dear God, please. You know, Jeff, honest to God, I'm sick and tired of the environment Nazis that have cost so many jobs across this country. And I'll tell you, when I hear these fools, it just shows how ignorant they are. You know, you cannot destroy this planet. And why? Because of rain, wind, fire, volcanic ash, and the sun is not going to burn out anytime soon. The earth constantly rejuvenates itself. And do you learn anything from this hurricanes? Mother Nature is going to do whatever she wants. You can't control it whatsoever. And now, with all this water in Florida, all these idiots in the environment, pesticides, anything that they worry about, it's all over the state of Florida now. The alligators are out of the canals and everything else, okay? Give me a break.
Russ, look, I agree with you. I completely agree with you. In fact, and thank you for that call. Look, these are environmental Nazis, and they're trying to enforce an ideological orthodoxy, and she played right to it. To give her her due, she knew it, you know, she knew which way the wind was blowing, and so she said what she had to say to win this pageant. What nobody wants to talk about is there was a study that just came out, major study. Take a guess what was the greatest period of global warming in Earth's history, in the history of Earth. Take a guess. Last, I don't know, 50 years? Okay, Jeff, last 100 years? You mean sometime during the Industrial Revolution? The Middle Ages. The Middle Ages. Medieval Europe was the period of greatest warming in Earth's history. Before the invention of the automobile, before the invention of fossil fuels, before the invention of anything. So it just shows you what a fraud and a hoax man-made global warming is. Brian in New Hampshire. Go ahead, Brian.
Hi, Jeff. You just hit the nail on the head. I was watching the pageant last night with great interest because my daughter actually competed in the Miss New Hampshire pageant, and in fact, her best friend wound up becoming Miss New Hampshire and competed. But I wanted to tell you that in the Miss New Hampshire pageant earlier this year, the questions were all anti-Trump, too. There was a question about climate change. There was a question about whether or not Trump should disclose his tax returns. And there was even a question about whether we should abolish the Electoral College and go with the popular vote to determine who was president because, of course, Trump won the Electoral College. My daughter will not be competing in the pageant anymore. This is because she has aged out. But I was just shaking my head last night because I, you know, think that, you know, this should not be, politicized. It should be about other things. I don't know if they should get rid of it entirely, but I don't think that it should be politicized like this. I think it's
Brian,
ridiculous.
Look, you nailed it. They're turning it now into a political soapbox. That's what this is. It's a political soapbox where they ask the finalists to out-bash Trump one another. So, okay, come on. How are you going to stick it to the president? No, are you really going to stick it to the president? And you know what I felt sorry for was Miss Missouri. Because honestly, I thought Miss Missouri should have won. And I look at Miss Missouri, and she was the only one that wouldn't stick it to the president on Russia collusion, and that's why she lost.
You're right, because she said that there's no evidence, and in this country, a man is still innocent until
proven guilty. You see, now, had she said lock him up, you know, Putin and Trump stole the election from Hillary. Miss Missouri would be Miss USA today. That's all. So she wasn't willing to whore herself out to the liberal elites to win the pageant. And that's why she lost. You know, you got to do what you got to do to win, I guess. 617-266-6868.
You know, Jeff, I was just done with these pageants after, well, in thinking May, when Miss USA was asked about healthcare and, you know, is it a right or a privilege? And she said that it was a privilege. And the next day she had to go on Good Morning America and walk back her comments. So if you don't say what they want you to say, you have to walk it back and you have to protect your image and everything else. So I'm just completely done with these pageants. It shouldn't be political at all. And when they don't agree with what you have to say, you have to walk it back. And it's not right, and it's not fair.
Let me ask you the ultimate question, Brittany. A pageant now where you have women in bikinis, in sexually suggestive poses, in high heels, parading themselves in front of the camera. Do you think in our day and age, just most women find it a turnoff, offensive, that it's just sexist and misogynistic, and we just don't need it anymore?
I don't watch it. I don't care to watch it. When I was in college, all of the girls were like obsessed with watching that, and also like the Victoria's Secret runway thing with that they have on TV. I don't have any desire to watch it. I don't care. I just don't understand why, you know, women just prance around in, you know, lingerie and bikinis on stage and get voted on their bodies. I don't really agree with it.
Well, no, it's on their answers too, Brittany.
That is true.
It's not just on their bodies.
That is true.
Hey, she gave a very good answer on climate change. Very good answer. 617. Very in-depth, very knowledgeable. Oh, she's a reader, you can see that. 617-266-6868. More with your calls next. Carlos, is it Ronnie? Okay, let's go to Ronnie in Boston. Go ahead, Ronnie.
Hey, thanks for taking the call, Jeff. I really appreciate it. How are you, man?
Good. Ronnie, I've got 30 seconds. Go.
Oh, man. Hey, they're campaigning for Trump, and they don't even realize it. All these high school voters that are in high school right now, they experience in their high school exactly what you saw on that pageant stage. Same for people in the workplace. You can talk about this all day, but you can't talk about anything else. They're doing our work for us, Jeff.
Ah, brilliant. I think people are sick of the left-wing censorship. And speaking of the man who's challenged it maybe the most, Steve Bannon, incredible interview on 60 Minutes. You gotta hear it to believe it. Next.
The voice of Boston is you. 680 WRKO Boston, 93.7 WEEI HD2 Lawrence Boston. It's 1 o'clock.